This day and time has been really interesting, to say the least, especially the past year and a half. And honestly, things, I mean, I'm not that old, give or take, but I mean, you all say that amongst yourselves. But in my lifetime, I've never seen things the way they are right now. And it's concerning. I think we need to pray harder.
Yeah.
And I think people say, what's it mean to pray harder? I think you just need to pray more and with more earnest and just cry out to God. I remember Reuben used to talk about people praying, they get off in the woods years ago, way back, and they'd get off in the woods and you could hear them praying. That's not such a bad idea anymore. But we often think, well, if this person was in, it takes a lot. If this person was in, it takes a lot. Honestly, who knows? But I think there's only one person that can fix things. And I think you all know that is Jesus, of course. And on top of that, on top of the things that's going on in the nation and then this virus is out and it's taking people's lives and rearranging people's lives. And on top of that, we've got our own personal problems. And we got, you know, marriages breaking up. We got diseases other than COVID taking over and things like that. And boy, you think about it, it gets pretty heavy sometimes. You think, Lord, I just can't. How can I carry this any longer? And honestly, you shouldn't. A lot of times we just don't want to give it up because we feel like we need to have our claws into it. And I think you need to, well, I know, you need to surrender it to God. Because that's, you can carry it all you want to, it's only going to get heavier, heavier, and heavier. So my advice to myself and to you is when things get heavy, give it to the Lord, because that's your only hope. I hope you enjoy this song. It's called... Sometimes the news of the day breaks your heart. Sometimes life leaves you lonely and scarred. It's the burden you carry, and you feel afraid. What can you do? What can you say? It's a Here at the cross, give it time, give it up to the Lord.
just come. Crawl if you must, lay it down. Here at the cross,
give it time. Give it up to the one who is strong.
This year it'll be 20 years since I got saved on Halloween. So that's pretty cool. I'm getting old. And even though I got saved when I was 7, I turned out, you know, didn't live life and go through normal teenage stuff. And I was a brat, that's what I'm saying. And I didn't change much. Every time I'd ever get into whatever, there's always like something pulling me back. You know, you need to go this way. You go this way, you're going to get in trouble. And, I was always with my family. Dear Lord, you can't hardly sin in that family. And, forget I'm on the stage of my parents sometimes. Grandparents let you get by with anything. Parents won't. Okay, I'm going to wrap this up. Anyway, I don't see too many people in here my age, but this song talks about what it's going to be like. And it's going to be like when we all get to heaven and stuff. And people my age, we have a whole lot of living to do before we really need to think about that. And but I love this song. My grandmother did it, and I'm not going to do what she did on it, but. If you know my grandmother, she kicked her shoes off and done some stuff. Her name was Peg, or Pat, Pag, P-A-G, Pag. That's from the mountain people out here. So anyway, let's do this song. It's called The Rising of the Sun, and I love it. Let's
Thank you.
Thank you.
Come on up, Mike. I just want to make mention before I forget it. We do have some product out in the foyer. It's not ours. But no, seriously, it kind of is ours. But Eli and Connie and myself, we're working on a project. It's about half done, and we're not sure when it's going to be out. But we think maybe by the first of the coming year, Lord willing. But we have some McCamey CDs and DVDs out there you might be interested in at the end of the service. So,
in the middle of it all, there is Jesus. Yeah. That's been my favorite song all night long. That was powerful. No. Not because it was a life. I love these folks. You don't ever have to worry about what you're getting when you call them. I directed choirs and did music for a lot of years. And I wouldn't book singers because I was afraid more of what they would say rather than what they would sing. You don't have to worry about that when you got the mechanics. Always a blessing. And we're going to ask our ushers to come at this time while they take a little vocal break. And let's help them out, folks. We were talking, and they're doing all their traveling now in an SUV and spending a lot of hours on the road when they go out and sing. As you all know, gas is not getting any cheaper. It's getting more and more and more expensive. So if you can help them out and so they can get their project out, I can't wait to get a copy of that. I'm looking forward to that already, and it takes money also to do that. So we're gonna go to the Lord in prayer, and we're gonna ask Him to bless this. And after we get through with the offering, they're gonna come back and sing a little bit more for us before we finish up tonight. Okay, let's have a word of prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank You that in the midst of it all, there You are. We are so reminded that in the midst of a fiery furnace, the old king looked in there and he said, "Didn't we see throw three men in? But I believe I see four walking around." He saw You and He said, "One is likened to the Son of God." And Lord, we're so thankful that when You appear, everybody knows it's You and You cannot be denied, Lord. We ask You to bless this offering, Father. Bless it and help it to go to help Roger and Connie and Eli out in their work for You, Lord. We thank You for what we felt tonight. In Your name we pray. Amen.
I mentioned earlier that we're working on a new project. Actually, it's our first project. this. Just as some useless information. A lot of people think this is a new group. And to this capacity, it is a new group. But I've been doing this, Connie and I have been doing this over 40 some years. I mean, we started when we was babies. And I haven't learned any more now than I did back then. She may know a little bit more than me. But like I say, we're working on a new project, and we got what it will consist of. We're bringing back about five or six McCamey songs that never necessarily were like hit songs or a lot of stage songs, but they were good songs. And we thought we'd bring them up to the forefront and put them on CD. And the other part of the CD will be new songs that we're getting from other writers. And I got to admit, we've got some good songs coming up. It's really good songs, and we really feel good about it. And one of them was written by Connie's sister, Cheryl. Cheryl is a very good songwriter, and she's written a lot of songs, a lot of them that the McCameys did, and some of them went to number one, some of them didn't, but we would do at least half a project, I would say, of just her songs, because they were that good. And I asked Connie a few minutes ago if she felt like she could do the song. We kind of rehearsed it earlier. And there's always this scare inside of you when you first do a song in front of people. And no doubt she's feeling that now. But it's okay. There's nobody here but us. And I feel like you're going to like this song. And I'm not going to go into a great deal of introduction with it. Jim Hamill said one time, it takes you longer to introduce a song than to sing it. You don't really need to do the song. So I'm not going to do that. But the song has a one-word title, and we hope you will enjoy it. It's called Still.
To make sense of it all.
troubled days. Still though the earth moves, I will not be afraid. He will not fail, he will not fall. He is King over all.
This is not actually a new song, but I kind of feel like calling it.